Mark Henry. Mark Gerald Henry, born June 12, 1971, is an American power lifter, Olympic weightlifter, strongman, and retired professional wrestler, who is currently signed to WWE under a Legends contract. He also works backstage as a producer. He is a two-time Olympian, 1992 and 1996, and a gold, silver, and bronze medalist at the Pan American Games in 1995. As a power lifter, he was WDFPF World Champion, 1995, and a two-time U.S. National Champion, 1995 and 1997, as well as an all-time Raw World Record holder in the squat and deadlift. Currently, he still holds the WDFPF World Records in the squat, deadlift, and total and the USAP American record in the deadlift since 1995. He is credited for the biggest raw squat and raw power lifting total ever performed by a drug-tested athlete, regardless of weight class, as well as the greatest raw deadlift by an American citizen. In weightlifting, Henry was a three-time U.S. National Weightlifting Champion, 1993, 1994, 1996, an American Open winner, 1992, a two-time U.S. Olympic Festival Champion, 1993 and 1994, and a NACOC champion, 1996. He holds all three senior U.S. American weightlifting records of 1993-1997. In 2002 he won the first annual Arnold Strongman Classic. Since joining the World Wrestling Federation, now WWE, in 1996, he has become a one-time WWF European champion and a two-time world champion, having held the ECW Championship in 2008, and WWE's World Heavyweight Championship in 2011. In April 2018 it was announced that Henry would be inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame class of 2018. Early life. Henry was born in Silsby, Texas. As a child, he was a big wrestling fan and Andre the Giant was his favorite wrestler. While attending a wrestling show in Beaumont, Texas, young Henry tried to touch Andre as he was walking down the aisle, but tripped over the barricade. Andre picked him up out of the crowd and put him back behind the barricade. When Henry was 12 years old, his father, Ernest, died of complications from diabetes. When he was 14 years old, Henry was diagnosed with dyslexia. Henry comes from a family in which almost all of the men are larger than average, especially his great uncle Chud, who was 6 feet 7 in, weighed approximately 500 pounds, never had a pair of manufactured shoes, and was known as the strongest man in the piney woods of East Texas. Henry played football in high school until his senior year, when he strained ligaments in his wrist during the first game of the year and scored below 700 on the SAT. Powerlifting career. By the time Mark Henry was in the fourth grade, he was 5 feet 5 inches and weighed 225 pounds, 102 kilograms. His mother bought a set of weights for him when he was 10 years old. During Henry's freshman year at Silsby High School, he was already able to squat 600 pounds, 270 kilograms, which was well over school record. As an 18-year-old high school senior, Henry was called the world's strongest teenager by the Los Angeles Times, and made it into the headlines in early 1990 for winning the National High School Powerlifting Championships and setting teenage lifting world records in the squat 832 pounds, 377 kilograms, and total 2,033 pounds, 922 kilograms. By the time Henry finished high school, he was a three-time Texas state champion with state and national records in all four powerlifting categories: the squat at 832 pounds, 377 kilograms, bench press at 525 pounds, 238 kilograms, and deadlift at 815 pounds, 370 kilograms, as well as the total at 2,033 pounds, 922 kilograms. At the Texas High School Powerlifting Championships in April 1990, Terry Todd, a professor of kinesiology at the University of Texas at Austin and former weightlifter, spotted Henry and persuaded him to go to Austin after he graduated to train in the Olympic style of weightlifting. In July 1990 at the USPF Senior National Powerlifting Championships, 19-year-old Henry came second only to the legendary six-time world powerlifting champion Kirk Karwoski. While powerlifting relies primarily on brute strength and power, which Henry obviously possessed, Olympic weightlifting is considered more sophisticated, involving more agility, timing, flexibility, and technique. There have been few lifters in history who have been able to be successful in both lifting disciplines. Mastering the technique of weightlifting usually takes many years of practice. But Henry broke four national junior records in weightlifting after only 8 months of training. In April 1991, he won the United States National Junior Championships. 20 days later he placed fourth at the U.S. Senior National Championships, and finished sixth at the Junior World Weightlifting Championships in Germany 2 months later. Only a few weeks afterwards, he became 1991's International Junior Champion in powerlifting as well. In Henry's first year in competitive weightlifting, he broke all three junior, 20 and under, American records 12 times, and became the United States' top super heavyweight, surpassing Mario Martinez. At the age of 19, Henry had already managed to qualify for the weightlifting competition at the 1992 Summer Olympics, where he finished 10th in the super heavyweight class. 10 months before the 1992 Olympics, Henry had begun training with Dragomir Syaroslin, a bronze medalist at the 1984 Summer Olympics, who said that he had never seen anyone with Mark's raw talent. After the Olympics, Henry became more determined to focus on weightlifting and began competing all over the world. In late 1992 he took the win at the USA Weightlifting American Open and further proved his dominance on the American soil by winning not only the US National Weightlifting Championships, but also the US Olympic Festival Championships in 1993 and 1994. At the 1995 Pan American Games Henry won a gold, silver, and bronze medal. Having reached the pinnacle of weightlifting on a national and continental level, he competed again in powerlifting and shocked the world by winning the ADFPA U.S. National Powerlifting Championships in 1995 with a 2,314.8 pounds raw powerlifting total. Despite competing without supportive equipment in contrast to the other competitors, Henry managed to outclass the lifter in second place by 286 pounds, defeating not only five-time IPF World Powerlifting Champion and 12-time USAPL National Powerlifting Champion Brad Gillingham, but also America's Strongest Man of 1997 Mark Filippi. In the process he set all-time world records in the raw deadlift at 903.9 pounds, 410 kilograms. And the squat without a squat suit at 948.0 pounds, 430 kilograms, as well as the all-time drug-tested raw total at 2,314.8 pounds, 1,050 kilograms. Later that same year in October, he competed in the Drug-Free Powerlifting World Championships and won again, even though he trained on the powerlifts only sparingly due his main focus still being on the two Olympic lifts. He not only became world champion by winning the competition but also bettered his previous all-time squat world record to 953.5 pounds, 432.5 kilograms, and his all-time drug-tested world record total to 2,336.9 pounds, 1,060 kilograms. In 1996 Henry became the North America, Central America, Caribbean Islands, NACOC, champion. He earned the right to compete at the Olympics by winning the U.S. National Weightlifting Championships in the spring of 1996 for a third time. During his victory Henry became senior U.S. American record holder, 1993-1997, in the snatch at 180.0 kilograms, 396.8 pounds, clean, and jerk at 220.0 kilograms, 485.0 pounds, and total at 400.0 kilograms, 881.8 pounds, improving all of his three previous personal bests. This 400 kilograms total, in the opinion of many experts in track field of international lifting including Dragomir Syaroslin, the 90SIXS coach of the US team was the highest ever made by an athlete who had never used anabolic steroids who was lifetime drug-free. By that time, at the age of 24, Henry was generally acknowledged as the strongest man in the world, even by many of the Eastern Bloc athletes who outrank him in weightlifting. No one in the history of the sports had ever lifted as much as him in the five competitive lifts, the snatch and the clean and jerk in weightlifting, the squat, bench press and deadlift in powerlifting. To this day, his five lift total is still the greatest in history by a fair amount, making him arguably one of the strongest men that ever lived, and stamp him, according to lifting statistician Herb Glossbrenner, as history's greatest lifter. In the months prior to the 1996 Summer Olympics in Atlanta, Georgia, Henry received more attention and publicity than any lifter in recent U.S. history. He guested at Jay Leno, Conan O'Brien, and Oprah Winfrey show and was featured on HBO Inside Sports and The Today Show. He was also featured in dozens of magazines including U.S. News and World Report, People Vanity Fair, ESPN The Magazine and Life, where he was photographed nude by famed artist Annie Leibovitz. During this period he connected with WWE owner Vince McMahon for the first time, which led to him signing a 10-year deal as professional wrestler. Henry improved his lifts to 407 pounds in the snatch and 507 pounds in the clean and jerk during his final 8 weeks of preparation for the 1996 Summer Olympics in Atlanta. Henry, at 6'4" tall and 414 pounds body weight, became the largest athlete in Olympic history and was voted captain of the Olympic weightlifting team. Unfortunately, he suffered a back injury during the competition and was unable to approach his normal performance level. Due to the injury, he had to drop out after his first clean and jerk attempt and finished with a disappointing 14th place. His appearance at the Olympics proved to be his last official competition in Olympic weightlifting, as he retired from weightlifting, vowing never to return unless the sport is cleaned up of anabolic steroid use. Since his career start as a professional wrestler shortly after the Olympics, he broke his leg in the fall of 1996. But by the summer of the following year he had rehabbed it enough to be able to compete at the USAPL National Powerlifting Championships 1997, where he won the competition to become the U.S. National Powerlifting Champion in the super heavyweight class again. He had planned to continue heavy training in powerlifting, although his travel schedule as a professional wrestler with the WWF, now WWE, has made sustained training difficult. Mark's WWF contract was unique in many ways, allowing him at least 3 months off each year from wrestling, so he can train for the national and world championships in weightlifting or powerlifting. Barring injury, Mark had originally hoped to return to the platform in late 1998, to lift for many more years, and to eventually squat at least 1,100 pounds without a squat suit and to deadlift 1,000 pounds. Although in early 1998 he was still able to do 5 reps in the bench press with 495 pounds, 3 reps in the squat with 855 pounds, with no suit and no knee wraps, and 3 reps in the standing press with 405 pounds in training, while traveling with the World Wrestling Federation, he never returned to compete again in official championships in favor of his wrestling career. He weighed 380 pounds at that time, and his right upper arm was measured at 24 by Terry Todd. By basically ending his lifting career at the age of 26, it is probable that he never reached his full physical potential as a professional lifter. Henry remains the youngest man in history to squat more than 900 pounds without a squat suit, as well as the youngest to total more than 2,300 pounds raw. He's the only person ever to have accomplished any of these feats at under 25 years of age. Personal powerlifting records. Powerlifting competition records, done in official powerlifting full meets. Career aggregate powerlifting total, best official lifts, 1,108.0 kilograms, 432.5 plus 265.5 plus 410, / 2,442.7 pounds, 953.5 plus 585.3 plus 903.9. Powerlifting gym records, unofficial. Career aggregate power lifting total, best unofficial lifts, 2,531 pounds, 1,006 plus 600 plus 925. Personal weightlifting records. Weightlifting competition records. Done in official competition. Weightlifting gym records, unofficial. All three done in training after the 1990 SIXS US Nationals, but prior to the Olympics 96. Combined lifting records. Professional wrestling career. World Wrestling Federation / Entertainment / WWE. Early career, 1996-1997. At the age of 24, Henry made his first appearance on World Wrestling Federation, WWF, programming on the March 11, 1996 episode of Monday Night Raw, where he press-slammed Jerry Lawler, who was ridiculing Henry while interviewing him in the ring. After Henry competed in the 1996 Summer Olympics, the WWF signed him to a 10-year contract. Trained by professional wrestler Leo Burke, his first feud in the WWF was with Lawler. At the pay-per-view event, SummerSlam in August 1996, Henry came to the aid of Jake Roberts, who was suffering indignity at the hands of Lawler. His debut wrestling match was at In Your House, Mind Games on September 22, 1996, where he defeated Lawler. The feud continued on the live circuit during subsequent weeks. On the November 4 episode of Raw, Henry served as a cornerman for Barry Windham in a match against Goldust. He was set to team with Windham, Mark Marrow, and Rocky Maivia to take on the team of Lawler, Goldust, Hunter Hearst Helmsley and Crush at Survivor Series, but was replaced by Jake Roberts when he was forced to withdraw from the event due to injury. On the November 17 episode of Superstars, Henry defeated Hunter Hearst Helmsley, Crush, and Goldust in a tug-of-war contest. Henry's career was then stalled as, over the next year, he took time off to heal injuries and engage in further training. In November 1997, he returned to the ring, making his televised return the following month. By the end of the year, he was a regular fixture on WWF programming, defeating Steve Lombardi on the December 15 episode of Raw, and beating the Sultan on the December 27 episode of Shotgun. Nation of Domination and Sexual Chocolate, 1998-2000. Henry joined the faction with Farouk, The Rock, Mustafa, and D'Lo Brown on January 12, 1998. After The Rock usurped Farouk's position as leader, Henry switched loyalties to The Rock. He also competed at WrestleMania 14 in a tag team battle royal with Brown as his partner, but they did not win. After The Nation disbanded, he engaged in a short feud with The Rock, defeating him at Judgment Day, In Your House with help from Brown, and then forming a permanent team with Brown, gaining Ivory as a manager. During the next year, Henry gave himself the nickname Sexual Chocolate, adopting a ladies' man character, and was involved in a romantic storyline with then-enemy China, which included a controversial angle with transvestite. During a match at the August 1999 SummerSlam pay-per-view between Brown and Jeff Jarrett for the WWF Intercontinental and WWF European Championships, both held at the time by Brown, Henry turned on Brown and helped Jarrett win the match and the titles. The next night, Henry was awarded the European title by Jarrett in return for his help. Henry lost the title 1 month later to Brown at the Unforgiven pay-per-view. The night after he tried to make up with Brown and later in the week claimed to be a sex addict, resulting in him attending a sex therapy session a week later where he claimed that he lost his virginity at 8 years old to his sister, and had just slept with her 2 days ago. He was part of a storyline about him overcoming sex addiction, which he accomplished thanks to The Godfather. After this, Henry turned into a fan favorite, and was seen on television romancing WWF veteran wrestler Mae Young as part of the Sexual Chocolate character. He feuded with Viscera during this time, as part of a storyline where Viscera splashed Mae Young while she was carrying Henry's child. Young later gave birth to a hand. Ohio Valley Wrestling and Strongman Competitions, 2000-2001. In 2000, Henry was sent to Ohio Valley Wrestling, OVW, to improve his conditioning and wrestling skills. In OVW, he teamed with Nick Dinsmore to compete in a tournament for the OVW Southern Tag Team Championship in mid-2001. Later that year, Henry's mother died, causing him to go on hiatus from wrestling. He felt he had to compete in the Super Bowl of weightlifting, the Arnold Strongman Classic, in honor of his mother, who gave him his first weight set when he was a child. 4 months prior to the contest, Henry began lifting the heaviest of weights and trained for the first time since 1997 for a major lifting competition. He had never been a professional strongman before, but in the coming contest he was to face the very best of the best of professional strongmen, such as the number one ranked strongman in the world, and defending World's Strongest Man competition winner of 2001 Sven Carlson, World's Strongest Man winner of 2006 Phil Pfister, World Powerlifting Champion of 2001 and Equipped Deadlift World Record Holder Andy Bolton, World Muscle Power Champion, Olympic Weightlifting Champion Raymond Bergmanis, and reigning America's Strongest Man of 2001 Brian Schoenfeld. Then on 22 February 2002 in Columbus, Ohio, the competition, consisting of four events, designed to determine the lifter with the greatest overall body power, began. Henry surprised everybody when he won the first event, setting a world record in the process by lifting the Apollon's axle three times overhead. Only three men in history had ever been able to press it at all. By deadlifting 885 pounds for two reps in the second event and easily pushing a 5.000+ lbs Hummer with nearly flat tires in the third event, Henry kept his lead continuously throughout the competition and never gave it up again. In the final Farmer's Walk event, Henry quickly carried the roughly 850 pounds of railroad ties up an incline, winning the whole competition convincingly to capture the winning prize, a $75,000 Hummer, a vacation cruise and $10 cash. Since Mark had only trained for 4 months and defeated the cream de la cream of worldwide strongmen, who had been practicing for years, his win was a shock for strongman experts worldwide, but remained basically unnoticed by the wrestling audience. Henry proved to be worthy of the title World's Strongest Man not only by winning the contest, but also by achieving it in record time. By doing so, he was again seen as the legit strongest man in the world by many lifting experts for a second time since 1996. Various feuds, 2002-2004. Henry returned to the WWE the next month and was sent to the SmackDown brand, where he developed an in-ring persona of performing tests of strength while other wrestlers took bets on the tests, but the gimmick met with little success. During this time he competed against such superstars as Chris Jericho and Christian. After being used sporadically on WWE, formerly WWF, television during 2002, as he was training for a weightlifting contest, and suffering a knee injury, Henry was sent back to OVW for more training. In August 2003, Henry returned to WWE television on the Raw roster as a heel, where he found some success as a member of Thuggin' and Buggin' Enterprises, a group of African Americans led by Theodore Long who worked a race angle in which they felt they were victims of racism and were being held down by the white man. During that time, Henry was involved in a brief program with World Heavyweight Champion Goldberg when former champion, Triple H, put a bounty on Goldberg. This was followed by a brief rivalry with Shawn Michaels, before he engaged in a rivalry with Booker T. After defeating Booker T twice, once in a street fight and once in a six-man tag team match, he lost to Booker T at the Armageddon pay-per-view in December 2003. At a practice session in OVW in February 2004, Henry tore his quadriceps muscle, and was out for over a year after undergoing surgery. Henry was then utilized by WWE as a public relations figure during his recovery, before returning to OVW to finish out 2005. World Championship Pursuits, 2005-2008. During the December 30th episode of SmackDown, Henry made his return to television, as he interfered in a WWE Tag Team Championship match, joining with M&M, Joey Mercury, Johnny Nitro, and Melina, to help them defeat Rey Mysterio and Batista for the championship. A week later on SmackDown, Henry got in a confrontation with the world heavyweight champion, Batista, and went on to interfere in a steel cage match between M&M and the team of Mysterio and Batista, helping M&M to retain their titles. Henry then had another match with Batista at a live event where Batista received a severely torn triceps that required surgery, forcing him to vacate his title. On the January 10, 2006 episode of SmackDown, Henry was involved in a battle royal for the vacant World Heavyweight Championship. He was finally eliminated by Kurt Angle, who won the title. A week later, Henry received assistance from Davery, who turned on Angle and announced that he was the manager of Henry. With Davery at his side, Henry faced Angle for the World Heavyweight Championship at the 2006 Royal Rumble in January, losing when Angle hit him with a chair, without the referee seeing, and pinned him with a roll-up. On the March 10th episode of SmackDown, Henry interfered in a World Heavyweight Championship match between Angle and The Undertaker, attacking the latter when he was seconds from possibly winning the title. Henry then performed a diving splash on Undertaker, driving him through the announcer's table. Henry was then challenged to a casket match by Undertaker at WrestleMania 22. Henry vowed to defeat The Undertaker and end his undefeated streak at WrestleMania, but The Undertaker defeated him. Henry had a rematch against The Undertaker on the April 7th episode of SmackDown. It ended in a no contest when Davery introduced his debuting client, the Great Khali. Khali went to the ring and attacked The Undertaker, starting a new feud and ending Henry's. During the rest of April and May, Henry gained a pinfall victory over the World Heavyweight Champion, Rey Mysterio in a non-title match. Henry entered the King of the Ring tournament, and lost to Bobby Lashley in the first round. He later cost Kurt Angle his World Heavyweight Championship opportunity against Mysterio, when he jumped off the top rope and crushed Angle through a table. Henry was then challenged by Angle to face off at Judgment Day. Henry then sent a message to Angle by defeating Paul Burkhill. At Judgment Day, Henry defeated Angle by count out. Although winning, Angle got his revenge after the match by hitting Henry with a chair and putting him through a table. Henry later went on what was referred to as a path of destruction, causing injuries to numerous superstars. Henry took out Chris Benoit and Paul Burkhill on this path of destruction, and attacked Rey Mysterio and Chavo Guerrero. These events led up to a feud with the returning Batista, whom Henry had put out of action with a legitimate injury several months beforehand. When Batista returned, he and Henry were scheduled to face one another at the Great American Bash in July. Weeks before that event, however, on the July 15, 2006 episode of Saturday Night's Main Event, Henry was involved in a six-man tag team match with King Booker and Finlay against Batista, Rey Mysterio, and Bobby Lashley. During the match, Henry was injured, canceling the scheduled match at the Great American Bash, as Henry needed surgery. Doctors later found that Henry completely tore his patella tendon off the bone and split his patella completely in two. Henry returned on the May 11, 2007 episode of SmackDown, after weeks of vignettes hyping his return. He attacked The Undertaker after a World Heavyweight Championship steel cage match with Batista, allowing Edge to take advantage of the situation and use his Money in the Bank contract. Henry then began a short feud with Kane, defeating him in a lumberjack match at One Night Stand. Shortly after, Henry made an open challenge to the SmackDown locker room, which nobody ever accepted. In the coming weeks, he faced various jobbers wrestlers who consistently lose to make their opponents look stronger and quickly defeated them all. On August 3rd, he claimed that nobody accepted the open challenge to step into the ring with him because of what he had done to The Undertaker, presenting footage of his assault on The Undertaker. The Undertaker responded over the following weeks, playing various mind games with Henry. Henry finally faced The Undertaker again at Unforgiven in September, losing to him after being given a last ride. Following an unscripted backstage interview, Henry burst into tears and fled from the arena. 2 weeks later, Henry lost a rematch to The Undertaker after The Undertaker performed a choke slam on Henry. After a short hiatus, Henry returned to WWE programming on the October 23rd episode of ECW, attacking Kane, along with the great Kali and Big Daddy V. Henry then began teaming with Big Daddy V against Kane and CM Punk, and was briefly managed by Big Daddy V's manager, Matt Stryker. At Armageddon, Henry and Big Daddy V defeated Kane and Punk. Before WrestleMania XXIV aired, Henry participated in a 24-man battle royal to determine the number one contender for the ECW Championship, but failed to win. ECW Champion and Various Storylines, 2008-2010. As part of the 2008 WWE Supplemental Draft, Henry was drafted to the ECW brand. At Night of Champions, Henry defeated Kane and Big Show in a triple threat match to capture the ECW Championship in his debut match as an ECW superstar. Upon winning the title, it was made exclusive to the ECW brand once again. Henry's title win came nearly a full decade after he was awarded the European Championship, which was back in 1999 and the only title he held in WWE. A few weeks later, Hall of Famer Tony Atlas returned to WWE to act as Henry's manager. Shortly after, ECW General Manager, Theodore Long, unveiled a new, entirely platinum ECW Championship belt design. In August, Henry defended the title against Matt Hardy at SummerSlam after getting himself disqualified. However, championships cannot change hands via disqualification, meaning that Henry retained the title. Henry later lost the title to Hardy at September's Unforgiven in the championship scramble match. Henry attempted to regain the championship throughout the end of 2008, and had a match against Hardy at No Mercy, but failed as he was unsuccessful. Henry and Atlas then engaged in a scripted rivalry against Finlay and Hornswoggle, which included Henry losing a Belfast brawl at Armageddon. At the start of 2009, Henry qualified for the Money in the Bank ladder match at WrestleMania XXV, and was involved in a series of matches with the other competitors on Raw, SmackDown, and ECW. He was unsuccessful at WrestleMania, however, as CM Punk won the match. In May, Henry began a rivalry with Evan Bourne, which began after Bourne defeated Henry by countout on the May 26th episode of ECW. On June 29th, Henry was traded to the Raw brand and rebuted for the brand that night as the third opponent in a 3-on-1 gauntlet match against WWE Champion Randy Orton, which he won, turning Henry into a face in the process. In August 2009, Henry formed a tag team with Montel Vontavious Porter and the two challenged the unified WWE Tag Team Champions Jerry Show, Chris Jericho and The Big Show, for the title at Breaking Point, but were unsuccessful. They stopped teaming afterwards, becoming involved in separate storylines, until the February 15, 2010 episode of Raw in which they defeated the unified WWE Tag Team Champions The Big Show and The Miz in a non-title match. The next week they challenged The Big Show and The Miz in a title match but were unsuccessful. At Extreme Rules, Henry and MVP fought for a chance to become number one contenders to the unified WWE Tag Team Championship, but were the second team eliminated in a gauntlet match by The Big Show and The Miz. Ultimately, the Hart Dynasty, Tyson Kidd and David Hart Smith, won the match. Henry mentored Lucky Cannon in the second season of NXT. Cannon was eliminated on the August 10th episode of NXT. In September, Henry began teaming with Evan Bourne, starting at the Night of Champions pay-per-view, where they entered a tag team turmoil for the WWE Tag Team Championship. They made it to the final two before being defeated by Cody Rhodes and Drew McIntyre. The team came to an end in October when Bourne suffered an injury and was taken out of action. Henry then formed a team with Yoshi Tatsu on the November 29th episode of Raw, defeating WWE Tag Team Champions Justin Gabriel and Heath Slater, after a distraction by John Cena. They received a shot at the championship the next week, in a fatal four-way elimination tag team match, which also included the Usos and Santino Marella and Vladimir Kozlov. Henry and Tatsu were the first team eliminated in the match. Hall of Pain and World Heavyweight Champion, 2011-2012. On the April 25, 2011 episode of Raw, Henry was drafted back to SmackDown as part of the 2011 WWE Draft. In the main event of the night, Henry attacked his teammates John Cena and Christian, turning heel in the process. On the May 27th episode of SmackDown, Henry participated in a triple threat match against Sheamus and Christian to decide the number one contender to the World Heavyweight Championship, which was won by Sheamus. On the June 17th episode of SmackDown, Henry was scheduled to face an angry and emotionally unstable Big Show, who warned Henry not to get into the ring. Henry ignored the warning and Big Show assaulted him before the match could begin. This act ignited a feud between the two. Henry attacked Big Show both backstage and during matches, while on the July 1st episode of SmackDown, Big Show's music played during Henry's match against Randy Orton, causing Henry to be counted out and costing him a shot at the